jug when it hurts like hell. I've never needed anyone so much. There's no one else I love, and I curse myself. 'Cause the right thing is to give you. Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. I'm Angel, this is Gaming with Angels, and the guy who's slapping his face is Jack. So we are gonna continue on with the Talos Margaret mission thing, and we're actually heading into here into the Warrens. Now, some of the stuff that I do off camera is it makes it easier for us for editing purposes. Apparently, a little bit of side boob or jack booty gets us kicked off, but I can decapitate somebody, and that right on, spot on, right there. So we're going to continue on here. I'm actually going to go ahead and tweak commands and bring everybody in because... There we go. There's all of them.
My dear, I've been waiting for you.
That would be why, because that does stall it out a little bit.
You are taking us somewhere warm, I trust.
We'll stand next to a fire, Chisargo,
and you'll be warm. I was worried about you going into the Thalmor embassy alone. You don't want to be here. No one wants to.
If anyone sneaks up on us, I'll smell them coming. Or I might not. We will see.
You don't dabble in magic much, do you? Can't say I blame you. I barely...
Warrens ain't for you. Trust me.
So, if you've ever played Enderal or, Fallout or anything, the Warrens is kind of like the underground, where you really don't want to be there, so, if you don't have to be. And apparently, I am lost, so... I'm gonna do this way. I don't know where the hell I am. That's okay.
Your job is to do what I say. And I say you have many nails and fittings to make before you even... ...to play.
Oh, I'm on the wrong side of town. That's the problem. Okay. I can fix that. That was the problem. Got it. Got it. That's me being stupid. No worries. Nope. Over here on the mines side, and I actually need to be back over here at the market, this area over here, because if I'm not mistaken, I gotta go into the inn. Yeah, it's been a while since I've played this one, because it's a whole Talos thing, and it's nothing against Talos, because he's an awesome character, did great things for Nirm. In Tamriel and stuff like that.
Warm
so,
food, warm drinks and warm beds.
But the idea is that
there something I can help you with?
Got to find evidence for.
It's a fine day with you around.
Klepper, you idiot! Can't you do anything right?
What? What did I do this time? I was just standing here.
You were just standing there when you were supposed to be serving drinks to our customers.
Shouldn't you be helping me then, wife of mine? Sharing my problems? Being my better half?
Wow, that's impressive.
I am your better half. And your better half is telling you to stop being an idiot and serve the customers their drinks.
That is not what I wanted to do. Do I not have the key? Guess I didn't pick it up, so...
Another drink, Kosnek. A porter with Arnleaf and Sons deserves nothing but the finest here.
Yes. All your drinks.
This is the Silver Blood Inn. I'll let you figure out who owns it by yourself. Ah, yes. Rented the nicest room we had for a whole month. Best we all forget about her. Bad luck to talk about the dead in Markarth.
No, you aren't.
Remember, ale is cheaper than blood in Markarth.
Is there something I can do for you?
I trust you aren't considering any thievery.
It does have a key. Okay.
Is Get there away from me. Something I can do for you?
Oh, I was just looking at what you had, so stop it. Zargo, get the hell out of the way. Well, let's go see if Margaret Body's still out in the market, because if it is, I'm just going to take the key off of her. It's easier.
You're taking us somewhere warm, I trust.
Holmes. I said Holmes, you backbiter. You have a crippled worker. Helping hand.
Nope.
My friend!
Hello, dear husband. Have you brought more silver jewelry for me to sell?
Yes, I have.
The bloodiest beef in the reach.
Adara made the rings herself. She is learning to bend the metal. Perfect.
Oh, and Lily did stop by.
Sorry, nothing for you.
Excuse me. Lily did stop by, and she gave us a letter from a friend. Don't know who that friend is, but apparently I need to talk to Waylon too, so we are going to go back into the Warrens. See if I can get a key from Waylon, because that would be extremely helpful. Oh, there she is.
And to think I was worried about you going into the Thalmor Embassy alone. Let's go.
Hello. You are pleasant company. Oh, yes. I know everyone who sleeps in the Warrens. Kind of the one who passes the keys around. I guess someone else will be taking his room now.
This is what us Nords were always meant to do.
Sorry, but you don't exactly belong here.
Right wrongs with strength, steel, and resolve.
Welcome to the Warrens. It's where you go when you can't afford a room anywhere else. About the time they opened the mines, someone got the idea to throw beds in here. Laborers, the sick, the lame, we're all
the
here.
Divine I'd associate with this place. Granted,
that's
Mars
right.
Temple is
Welcome to Markarth, traveler. Thank the divines you can choose to live somewhere else. You've done well.
As far as I know, this is the only city the dwarves built for now.
I'm right behind you.
You know, you're right in front of me. Much of a room, is it?
I was worried about you going into the Thalmor Embassy alone.
You gotta kiss the wife because you don't want her all upset and mad and everything, and that would be, like, super bad. She's kissing his forehead, but whatever. Okay, we gotta find out who N is. Oh,
huh?
Look at
that. You've been digging around where you don't belong. It's time you learned a lesson. Someone who doesn't like you asking questions. Come on, let's see what you're made of.
You're just going to stand there and kick it? Fight back!
That's all you got!
You're just going to stand there and kick it? Fight back!
No! No!
You're just going to stand there and kick it? Fight back!
That's it. That's all you got.
The fact that I can roundhouse kick him is makes me very happy.
You're just going to stand there and kick it? Fight back!
You're making me angry.
Who taught you to fight? Put those hands up!
It's funny that, like, nobody is trying to stop this, and, like, this is just one big-ass frickin' brawl and shit. And they're just like, get your hands up! Who taught you how to fight, you know?
Do your worst.
Who taught you to fight? Keep those hands up!
Enough! This ends now! God, I'll get you! Son of a...
I just got gambled on. 12 septums on the big one! I'm like twice the guy's size, so.
Who taught you to fight? Yeah. Those hands up!
I'll tear you to pieces.
You're just going to stand there and kick it? Fight back!
Damn you!
Where the fuck are you going? Dude!
Enough of this! You're making me angry!
Who taught you to fight? Keep those hands up! Who taught you to fight? Keep those hands up!
You mangy piece of pit bait.
Keep those hands up.
I was sent by Nepos the Nose. The old man hands out the orders. He told me to make sure you didn't get in the way. That's all I know, I swear. Nepos is in charge. That's all I know.
Uh-huh.
Khajiit got your back.
So...
I've got your back.
Okay, so I gotta run back to the other side of town here. Said Lily did leave us a letter, or bring us a letter, I should say.
Excuse me.
No.
Do you know anything about this house?
No.
Seen anyone enter?
No. That is the player home.
So.
And no, I have absolutely no idea where I'm going, to be fair.
Need something?
Come on in. The Silverblood Inn has plenty of strong drink and clean rooms.
I work silver.
My daughter and his father.
His father, Klepper, is the one you want to talk to. I just clean up.
What can I do for you, friend?
I've done well.
Something simple.
Everything is splendid, thank you.
She didn't want to talk to you.
What do you need, handsome?
Well, maybe we could spend a little.
I'm what you'd call a soldier of fortune. Make me an offer.
Let me think about
it. Just might
is there something I can do for you?
Give us until a coin, Koznak. You'll just spend it on cheap ale anyway. Like you won't do different? I'm a cripple. I have a reason to be drinking.
You're very sweet.
And I'm a porter with no shipments
coming in. Of course, but I can't just hand that over. Privacy, after all. Right. You adventuring types would never go into a room just to steal everything. Well, I guess Margaret isn't around to complain. It's yours. I should remind Clepper to clean this place up.
The man I married would never speak of leaving his home.
I just don't know if I can keep you safe.
We will keep each other safe, no matter what.
All right. Meeting at the Treasury House later today took them long enough. These people act like they own everything. Sonar Silverblood is the younger brother, but he's obviously the one in charge. Makes all the deals, bullies local landowners into selling to him. Even employs that wispy girl at the door to deter troublemakers like me. General Tullius is growing impatient, but I'll bring back the deed to Sidna Mine. All my life, I won't allow a group of Stormcloak sympathizers to own the prison to the most notorious criminals of the Reach. They say no one escapes. Why? Is it really that secure? Maybe I've played my hand too soon by rushing to the confrontation with Thonar. There are shadows around every corner in this city, and I know I'm being watched.
You are taking us somewhere warm, I trust.
Look at you. Bye now.
Hi there. Sure thing. It's yours for a day. I'll show you to your room. Right this way.
Frobby, my dear loving wife. Could you please
still
clean
here?
Out our guest rooms?
Let me know if there's anything else you need.
Yourself, Klepper. It's not like you do anything important around here.
No, just check in the guests and manage the coin. And keep a roof over your head. No, nothing important.
All right, we're gonna go ahead and get Jack to sleep for a little bit. and start this again in the morning because it is foggy as shit, it is dark as shit, and that makes it very difficult to be able to see stuff, especially in Markarth. So, because, you know, fog is gray, Markarth is made of stone, which is gray, and, well, you should probably get the idea from there.
How did you manage to cripple yourself?
Jezargo is eager to hear how these scrolls are working.
Pickpocket. You're lying. You're not quick enough to be a pickpocket. What's the real reason?
Khajiit guards your back.
Fell off the top of the cliff after a drunken party.
Can I help you?
Bella. I don't buy that story either. Too bad.
Everything is splendid. Thank you.
You. I've seen you snooping around, asking questions. Back off. You don't want to know what happens to troublemakers here. Funny. This is your last warning, outsider. We keep the peace here. Stay out of our business.
There you are.
If anyone sneaks up on us,
I've got this pig I'm supposed to deliver. Your help only. Not.
We will see.
There you are.
There we
I've
go.
Been looking everywhere for you. I've got this thing I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only. Let's see. Looks like that's all. I have to leave.
Well, that was simple enough. I just had to pay my taxes, which is, you know, fine. I don't mind doing that.
Yes.
Excuse me.
Nope.
Do you know anything about this?
Nope.
House? Seen anyone enter?
I'm just wondering if it's one of these over here by the Jarl's Court. Oop, nope, there's one down there. Okay, so I was right. It's just one of them over here. I'm gonna keep snooping because, well, I'm gonna keep snooping. That's why.
And to think I was worried about you going into the Thalmor Embassy alone.
You just let old Nana know if you need anything. All right, dear?
What are you doing here? I told them no visitors. What did you expect? That no one was going to notice you butting into business that wasn't yours? The guards know who holds the purse strings in this city, and I don't like snoops. Markarth is my city. You have no right looking into my business. Now get out.
I'm right behind you.
I'm a busy man. Half this city.
Oh, what? Shit.
By the gods, Betrid! The blood of Markarth is... What was that?
Never. Oh my god! What the fuck just happened? Okay, no. I don't even know what the hell happened. Like, bitch just like jumped off the fucking deep end. I mean, maybe I need to talk to her first. Okay, let's try this again.
Good to see you. You've done well.
I'm married to Thonar Silverblood. Keep that in mind while you're speaking to me. He's the real head of this family. He may not be the eldest, but all the work that keeps us respected is handled by my Thonar. My dear Vagrant, we're the only family worth knowing in Markarth. We own everything in this city, even the jail. And guess who owns the Silverblood Inn? Not that we named it that, the people just insisted. You
sits
have
her
face.
Lap, pisses off the husband. Because I would totally do it.
Back from some adventure, I bet. For one, the landowners of the Reach. It goes without saying that they rely heavily on us for our silver and support. All the miners, farmers, and laborers in the Reach get their daily wages through us. Nepos the Nose handles that part of our business. He has a way with the workers. Good luck to you.
Can I help you?
Yes. You want Thonar Silverblood. He handles all the family business. If you're here to talk politics, though, you'd want his brother, Thongvor. He spends most of his time in Understone Keep. It's an old family, very well respected throughout the Reach. The Silverbloods run nearly all the lands in this hold, as well as the local inn. And of course they own Sidna Mine, the finest prison and source of silver in Skyrim. I'm afraid he's asked not to be disturbed. He has important business. Riches are a gate opener around here. Head right in.
Thank you.
Don't be a stranger.
Need something?
So apparently if I don't pick the lock, maybe she won't kill me. I mean, you know, there's always that.
What are you doing here? I told them... The Imperial Agent. That's right, I knew. How many dogs is the Empire going to send after me? This is my business. My city. You Empire lovers should learn to stay out of it. Now get out!
By the first one!
What? By the gods, veteran!
I am staying out of this.
What was that? Killed her. Damn Madinok. Damn his forsworn backside. No, you're not. You want to know what the forsworn really are? They're my puppets. I have their king rotting in Sidna Mine. He was supposed to keep them under control. My prison. The source of half the silver in Skyrim. The most secure prison in Tamriel. No one escapes. I thought keeping Madinok down there would keep him under control.
I'm more of a heavy armor woman.
Madinok. The king in rags. While we were off fighting the elves in the Great War, Madinok was busy ruling over the Reach. Until Ulfric came and put them down. When their uprising was crushed, I had Madinok brought to me. He was a wild animal, but a useful one. I offered him a stay from execution, if he used his influence to deal with any annoyances that came up. Competitors, agents, idiots. So I've let him run his little forsworn rebellion from inside Sidna mine. Now he's out of control.
Well, I'm glad I'm not fighting them.
You already got what you wanted, you damn hound. This is your fault. You and Madanak are animals, and I'll see you both rot to death in Sidna mine for this. Now get out of my house!
Gesargo is eager to hear how the scrolls are working.
Get out of my house.
Every time
now.
I think about what happened wrong. And daughter.
Kajit,
I'm glad we gave Mova and Alva what they deserved.
Thonar is apparently not as careful with his employment choices as he thinks he is, which is actually kind of funny to me. I might do that. Tower of Dawn. It's been a long time since I did that one, too. I forgot you had to kill the old lady.
If anyone sneaks up on us, I'll smell them coming. Or I might not. We will see.
Okay.
I work silver, like my father, and his father before him. I'm impressed.
Happen to bribe everybody in town to talk to somebody is a pain in the ass, just so y'all know.
Excuse me. What's your business here?
None of your fucking business. Actually, you know what? I'll probably talk to you first.
You again. What are you doing here? If you must know, I'm the maid. And the master of the house is old and needs his rest. So if you don't have any business, leave.
Wait. It's okay, my dear. Send him in.
Yes, Nepos.
Wow.
You heard him. Go on in.
I'm sorry about my housekeeper. She's a little protective of me. Now, what is it you want?
That's a hell of a nose.
Ah, yes. You've proven to be a real bloodhound. Well, you've sniffed me out. I've been playing this game for almost 20 years, sending the young to their deaths, all in the name of the Forsworn. And I'm tired. So tired. Because my king told me to. Madanok. When the uprising fell at the hands of the Nords, they threw him in the mines. I don't know how, but he lives. I get his messages, and I hand out his orders without question. My dear boy, what makes you think you're getting out of here alive? You were seen coming in, The girl at the door is a Forsworn agent masquerading as a maid. You aren't the first one to have gotten this far. You won't be the last. He is the King in Rags, a man who once held all the Reach within his grip. He stokes the passions of the downtrodden in this city, directs them to kill the enemies of the Forsworn in our name. All from inside Sidna Mine, a Nord prison. The irony is quite thick. Markarth and the Reach are our lands. That is why we are the Forsworn. We cannot claim the home that is rightly ours. But then, during their war with the Elves, we had our moment. We drove the Nords out of the Reach in a great uprising. Then Ulfric and his men came. Those of us who didn't run were executed, except for myself, my king, and a handful of others. I bid you safe travels.
Not the best,
huh? And here we go.
Oh, no, you don't. Ah! Ah! That's our best.
Guilt-ridden in my old age, so many of the young sent to their deaths, all in the name of the Forsworn, all in the name of Madinok, my king, who watches us from behind the iron bars of Sidna Mine. How long have I served you? Since the uprising against the Nords? Was there ever a time when all that violence hasn't overshadowed our destinies? What choice do I have but to do as I am instructed?
You are taking us somewhere warm, I trust.
Just had to go and cause trouble. Now we have to pin all these recent murders on you. Silence witnesses. Work, work, work. You think you're the only one who knows that? We had a nice little deal going between Tonar and Madinok until you showed up. You'll have plenty of time to take it up with the King in Rags while you're serving a life sentence in Sidna Mine.
Doing it.
You'll never leave Markarth.
Hi, the champion of Boethia.
Let the fight begin.
your
eyes.
You need to do better than that, Face.
Works too.
Damn you.
Kill!
Now you don't have to quiet anybody.
You are taking a... some warm, I trust.
I've got your back. Trace is dead. I'm right behind you.
I killed all the storm cloaks. And that would be time. So when we come back, we're going to go to the mine, down to Sidna Mine, and dig a little bit deeper. So there's two ways you can go about this. You can either go quietly and you go to the prison and you continue the quest, or you can kill them all and then go sneak into the prison and break out Mednok. See you guys next time. Thanks for watching, everybody.